Hey guys, welcome back to the wonderful world of RLCraft. Today I'm going to be explaining how to make dragon steel gear. You technically cannot do this in current standard RLCraft 2.8.2, but this feature more than likely will be added in the upcoming patch 2.8.3, whenever that comes out. For now though, you need to update your Ice and Fire mod and Spartan Fire mod in order to do everything I will mention in this video. If you are using the Twitch launcher, you can update your mods by unchecking this box in your profile options. You then scroll down and click the arrow to update the Ice and Fire mod, Dragons in a New Life, and the Spartan and Fire mod. If you are using a standard method of playing RLCraft, go into your mod files and delete the old Ice and Fire mod and the Spartan Fire mod, and download the newest version from whatever source you are using. Be warned though, the new updated mods seem to sometimes cause dragons to become unkillable in multiplayer worlds. In single player though, everything seems fine. If you want to still try it for a server though, you can usually go back to the previous version of the mods at your download source very simply. Now on to the fun part. Now that you have updated your mods, the new Dragonsteel items can be found when searching for them, but how do you acquire them? Well, these items, as you will notice, are insanely powerful. And as an attempt to balance this equipment, the game made it rather difficult to procure. You need to either trap a dragon or have a pet dragon that you raised on your own. To trap a dragon, you will need a dragon bone wall and an iron chain. The other walls may work, but the dragon bone wall works 100%. Craft the wall with 6 dragon bones. To craft the iron chain, all you need is 20 iron nuggets. 4 iron nuggets for each chain link, and you will need 5 arranged like so. The iron chain is like a lead, but unbreakable, so that is also useful for luring mobs around for farms and the like. You now are faced with the challenge of actually getting this chain on a dragon. The easiest way to do this is to go up to a dragon, place the bone wall next to it, then right-click the dragon with the chain in hand, and then right-click the bone wall. Now, if you have not been eaten or burned to a crisp, you will have successfully trapped a wild dragon. If you have a pet dragon that you hatched from an egg that you got from a tier 5 female dragon though, then you can avoid the whole trapping aspect. Next, you will need to build a dragon forge. You will need 17 dragon forge bricks that are made with dragon scale blocks and stone bricks, 8 blocks of dragon bone, a dragon forge aperture that is made with 4 iron ingots and 4 more dragon forge bricks, and a dragon forge core that is made with a dragon heart surrounded by 8 more dragon forge bricks. Since you may hate math, you will need 360 dragon scales and 2 stacks of stone bricks. Luckily, all the scales do not need to be all the same color, but that will still take a while if you start from scratch. Also, you will need 72 dragon bones in total for the 8 dragon bone blocks. If you are trying to get fire dragon steel gear, you will need a trapped or pet fire dragon, and you will need to use the fire equivalent blocks when making the forge. And for ice dragon steel gear, you will need a trapped or pet ice dragon, and you will need to use the ice equivalent blocks when making the forge. For ice dragon forges, you can find dread dungeons in frozen spruce forest biomes and frozen tundras though. And inside these dungeons you can find ice dragon forge bricks, ice dragon forge apertures, and ice dragon forge cores sometimes on the highest level of the dungeon. To enter these dungeons you will need to defeat a keymaster nearby that will spawn near your character when you wander around. This can occur anywhere within a few hundred blocks of the dungeon or so, and then you will collect the gravemaster's key that it drops. You will right click the door to enter with the key in hand to get inside. Since it is so expensive to make a forge, the bricks you collect from this dungeon can certainly save you a lot of time when making an ice dragon forge at least. And also, the spawners in these dungeons don't seem to ever disappear, so this area can make for a good XP farming area. Back to the forge though, you place the blocks down on the ground nearby your tamed or trapped dragon like so. There is 3 layers of 3x3 bricks to the forge. On the first layer, the dragon forge bricks go in a plus sign, and the dragon bone blocks go in the corners. On the second layer, you will need 7 Dragonforge bricks arranged in a U-shape, a Dragonforge core in the middle, and a Dragonforge aperture at the top. For the third and top layer, the arrangements of the blocks is the exact same as the bottom layer. Now that the forge is completed, you will right-click a center block on any side of the forge to open it, and you will place iron ingots and dragon's blood inside. If you have a fire dragon trapped or tamed, you will use fire dragon blood and vice versa for ice dragons. To get dragon blood, instead of right-clicking the dead dragon with open hands for scales, you will right-click the dragon with empty bottles in hand that you make with 3 glass. You can also get ice dragon's blood from ice shaman and ice craftsman villagers in cold biomes. They trade sapphires instead of emeralds, but you can take advantage of their trades rather easily. The gear you make requires 30 in attack for weapons or 30 in defense for armor, but the items are so incredibly strong and cool looking. All this hard work is certainly worth it. With that, I'm going to wrap up. I hope this video helped you guys understand how to make the newly added Dragonsteel armor and weapons efficiently. This gear set may not be implemented by RLCraft's mod author in the future with the same stats or even at all, but most likely will be, and you will be ready for it if and or when that time comes. Take care of yourselves, everyone. Bye-bye.